235. It's so funny, I was gonna sing this one this morning, or did we sing it this morning? I wanted to sing it this morning, but I don't know. Oh, Brother Phil, I think, got me sidetracked there, but, yeah. Once like a bird in the night, away from my sorrow I fell. But Jesus came in, Christ in me, and glory to God, he set me free. He set me free, yes, he set me free. He broke the bonds of prison for me. I'm glory bound, my Jesus is faithful. Glory to God, he set me free. Now I am flying higher each day. Darkness of night has drifted away. My feet are planted on higher ground, and glory to God, I'm homeward bound. He set me free, yes, he set me free. He broke the bonds of prison for me. I'm glory bound, my Jesus is faithful. Glory to God, he set me free. Life is faded and death is found. My love is bruised now, turned me around. Daily I'm worthy, I'm praying to him. Glory to God, I'm going through. He set me free, yes, he set me free. He broke the bonds of prison for me. I'm glory bound, my Jesus is faithful. Glory to God, he set me free.
Amen.
Well, Terry, you got one or two or three or eight, or ten?
Getting that age now, if I sit too long, I start stiffening up.
Or fall asleep.
I'll feel like that someday when I get old too, so.
You know, it is amazing to me since I've become a Christian that people want to limit the discussion about the resurrection to a day.
Yeah.
You know, it's popular to talk about Easter on Easter. And Christmas on Christmas, you know. But for me, Christmas and Easter is an everyday occurrence.
Amen.
And it's just something, people don't expect you to come out and talk about stuff like that. It's not even Christmas, what's he doing? I ain't sung this one in a long time, a friend of mine wrote it, but it's a good song. There's a pathway that's leading to a cross on a hill. And if you've never traveled this pathway,
yes, amen.
You'll stand there looking at the price paid for you. Will you receive it, take it or leave it? Which one will you do? Don't leave him hanging. Just walk away. Don't wait any longer. You need him today. Don't keep from hearing his cries ringing.
say amen.
Just sleep in pain.
Yes, Lord.
As you travel this pathway, you will see and learn. Some leave without you. Never return, but they'll find only sadness and sorrow.
Yes, amen. Bless the Lord.
Amen. Lord bless you.
True happiness shows on the faces of those who don't leave in pain. Don't leave in pain.
Mm-hmm. Hey Dave, I'm gonna do a song. I can't get this off my mind. I've been singing it for in the car and I'm at home and stuff. And it has a good message to it. Just listen to the words.
I love you, Lord, for your mercy never fails me all my days. I've been held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up, when I lay my head down, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. Cause all my life you have been faithful, and all my life you've been so, so good. Every breath that I'm able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have brought me through the fire in dark days. You are closer like no other. I know you as a father. I know you as my friend. And I'm gonna sing of the goodness of God. Cause all my life you have been faithful.
Amen.
And all my life you've been so, so good.
Amen.
Every breath that I'm able, oh, I'm gonna sing of the goodness of God. Cause your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, is running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after me. Cause all my life you have been faithful.
Amen.
And all my life you've been so, so good. Every breath that I'm able, oh, I'm gonna sing the goodness of God. Oh, I'm gonna sing the goodness of God.
Amen. Good song. Amen. Anybody else? All right. Which one do you think? Who's got it? You got something on your heart, Brother Terry?
No, you got it, didn't you?
There's a certain time of year I like to go over certain passages, and you know what? It's one of them times.
I like that song, Josh.
That's a good one.
All my life you have been faithful. I wish I could say that about me.
Mm-hmm.
I can't. I failed more times in a day than I wanted to admit. But he's good. He's faithful. And he does come running after us, amen. He does, whenever we wrong and we pass, you know, we trespass and we do things. He's the one who's quick to want us to restore that fellowship.
Amen.
We're the ones who take the Lord.
Yeah.
But I'm thankful thankful for that mercy. Thank you for the, scripture says God hath for his sake forgiven us. Amen.
Yeah,
he's done it. He's forgiven us for Christ's sake, because we don't deserve it. We don't deserve it. When you turn in the book of Matthew chapter 28, Matthew chapter 28, looking at the first verse. Leading up to this, we know that chapter 27 tells us the account of Christ crucified. And we can maybe see depictions. One of the movies that Hollywood put out, the Passion of Christ, did a pretty good job of depicting the suffering, but I don't even think they were close to what Jesus went through. Because besides the physical suffering he endured, he also had the weight of the sin of the whole world upon his shoulders. And he bore it all. I mean, beaten, afflicted. No man should have been able to withstand what he did, but he did anyways. And then he went to the cross, he died. And then he was buried, and they put him in the sepulcher. And because of the oncoming Sabbath, it was all they could do. They wanted to do more for him, his disciples, the women that we're going to read about. They wanted to do more, but they were limited. And there were some things that got in their way. Okay, so we want to look at the things that got in their way, but yet did not keep them from serving him and ultimately worshiping him, okay?
Amen.
So look in verse 28, chapter 28 with me, I'll begin reading. In the end of the Sabbath, as it began to dawn toward the first day of the week, came Mary Magdalene and the other Mary to see the sepulcher. Behold, there was a great earthquake, for the angel of the Lord descended from heaven, came and rolled back the stone from the door and sat upon it. His countenance was like lightning, and his raiment white as snow. And for fear of him, the keepers did shake, and became as dead men. The angel answered and said unto the women, Fear not ye, for I know that ye seek Jesus, which was crucified. He is not here, for he is risen. As he said, come see the place where the Lord lay. Amen. Let's bow our heads just for a moment. Father, dear God in heaven, we bow before you tonight. We thank you, Lord, for this gathering, for the opportunity and privilege to be in the house of God. And Lord, we pray for them that once had a desire to be here. We pray, God, that you reinstill that in their heart. Them that are unable and would like to be here, Lord, I pray that you make a way they also may attend and, Lord, worship and with the community of your believers, Lord. But ultimately, Lord, we pray that every heart here, Lord, including ours, Lord, that we'll be brought nearer to you. Draw us nearer to you and help us to lift up the name of Christ, our Lord and Savior. Father, we can do nothing on our own. We stand and hide behind the cross and pray for your touch, your anointing, that you would speak to every heart as you would intend to tonight. In Jesus' precious and holy name, we ask you for your glory and honor. Amen. Amen. So there's some things tonight that Paul said, when I would do good, evil was present. And you know, there's some things, whether they be evil or just things that come up that will try to keep us from doing what we need to, you know. These women wanted to anoint the body of Jesus. They cared for it. They loved him. They walked with him. They followed him for 3.5 years in his ministry. And here he died, and they were unable to do what they wanted to do, you know.
Amen. Lord,
and we find that the first thing that got in their way was the Sabbath. You know, because they were not allowed to do certain things on the Sabbath. You know, they were only allowed to go certain places. There were certain works that could not be done on the Sabbath because it was a day of rest.
Yeah.
But I like what the Bible says. In the end of the Sabbath, as it began to dawn toward the first day of the week, I want you to see, if you can, these women leaning toward
They're waiting. They're like runners in the blocks. And they're waiting for their opportunity. They can't wait to get there. Amen?
Amen.
And you know what? There was a time when God's people had that attitude about worship in the house of God. Amen. There was a time when they would say like David, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of God. They got glad before they got here. Amen. They got glad about coming here. They got glad with others that were going there. Amen. And they didn't wait till they got in the pew and you sang their song. You didn't have to get up and preach their message for them to get happy. Amen. They were happy before they got here. These women had already prepared themselves to do what they were going to do. Amen. The Bible says, as it began to dawn, toward, look at all these words, as it began, toward. They're not there yet, but in their heart they're there.
They're ready.
Amen. Amen. I want you to get that. The Sabbath got in their way, but as it began in the end of the Sabbath, as it began to dawn toward the first day of the week, it says, came Mary Magdalene and the other Mary to see the sepulchre. See, the next thing that were separating them from their Savior was a sepulchre. Yeah. You know, there was something, there was a wall between them, you know. And you know, there's so many people. Now, I'm not saying in connection to a sepulchre so much, but there is a separation where people are and they can't get to where they want to be.
Yeah,
or to be with one that, you know. Because all these things come up, you know. And so many people, you know, there's people that limit themselves. As someone said tonight, if they can't get a hold of their preacher, they can't get a hold of God.
Yeah, amen.
If they can't get to their church, they can't worship.
Yep.
You know, if they can't get to their hymn, you know what? I am so glad that God's bigger than that, aren't you? Aren't you glad that God can come right where you are tonight?
Yeah.
He can come in your room. He can come and visit you right where you're at tonight, amen? Yeah. I don't got to dress up for God to see me.
Amen.
The sepulcher was there. But not only was there a sepulcher, there was a stone. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
The Bible says they came to see the sepulcher, and behold, there was a great earthquake. For the angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone. So not only the Sabbath and the sepulcher, but there was a stone. Somebody had rolled a big old stone in front because they said, you know what? His disciples are going to come and steal him away.
That's right, amen. Yep.
So here's what we're going to do. We're going to appoint some soldiers. And we're going to put a seal on that stone. So now you've got a stone, but it's not an ordinary stone. It's a stone that's been sealed under authority of a Roman Empire.
Yep. Okay? Amen.
And it's guarded by Roman soldiers who weren't little sissies of that day. Amen. They were standing, and you know what their charge was? You don't let nobody in there, and you don't let nobody out.
Well, that was right.
But you know what? These women came, as we read, the Bible says they came to see. Aren't you glad? Aren't you glad no matter what the devil puts in front of you tonight, when you decide, I am going to church, and I am going, I'm not going for Brother Gary, not that that would be wrong, but I'm going to see Jesus.
Amen. Yep. Amen.
That's why I go to church for.
Amen.
I don't care what, I ain't going to be seen, I ain't going for a show, I'm going to see Jesus.
Amen.
Now there may be some things come up. You may get here and your least favorite person in the whole kingdom of God is sitting right in front of you. But you know what? That don't matter. Amen.
That's right, amen.
That don't matter. Hey, if anything else, it's a it's an opportunity to show mercy and grace and love. But they came, the Bible says, to see. In spite of the Sabbath, in spite of the sepulcher, in spite of the stone, in spite of the seal, and in spite of the soldiers.
They still came.
They still came to see.
Amen.
And then there was the sound. Now, sometimes they say that church gets too noisy here. Some people don't want to go where it's going. They want to be real quiet, refined, dignified. Kind of like a cemetery. Okay? But you know what? I like it when there's life stirring.
Yeah, man, me too.
You know what they do when a baby's born? They smack that baby. Why? They want it to cry.
Yeah.
Why? Because they want to know that it's alive.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yep.
Amen. They want to take that deep breath. Amen. I've been in churches where if you thought somebody was back there smacking people when they're yelling, you know? But they were worshiping God. They got loud. I don't, my loud don't bother me. I don't think it bothers God either.
Amen.
Oh, absolutely. Matter of fact, the Bible says when he speaks, it sounds like thunder.
Yeah. Amen.
So they came, and the Bible says, behold, there
was a great earthquake, for the angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone from the door and sat upon it.
I always like that. I bet that angel, I did feel like that angel had a little bit of an attitude. You know? They rolled back the stone. The stone was supposed to keep us from him, from anybody getting to Jesus and bringing him out. That's what they thought was going to happen. Yeah. His disciples were going to come and steal him out. Well, here's this angel. Soldiers were laying on the ground shaking in their boots. Amen. The seal's broken. The stone's rolled back. And here's a big old angel sitting up on top of it. You know? I just like that. I think he had an attitude.
Amen.
And his countenance was like lightning, raiment with white snow. And for fear of him, the keeper did shake and became as a dead man. Can I just say this? When you make up your mind that you're going on for God, God will do whatever it takes to get you there.
Amen.
I remember two that got thrown in jail over there in Acts. Amen. And the Bible says at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed.
Sang.
Amen. Prayed. They sang.
You had a good time.
They prayed and sang praise. And you know what God did? God picked a lock with an earthquake.
Yeah.
Think
yeah.
about that. All the locks were open, all the doors, all the shackles and chains fell off, and yet nobody died and nobody left. Yeah. Amen.
Do you love
I tell you what, you get stuff like that going on in church, you don't have to worry about people leaving.
No.
They'll hang around and see what else is going to happen next. Amen. Amen. Remember when over in Acts, on the day of Pentecost, they were praying, they're all one mind, one accord, they prayed, and all of a sudden there was a mighty rushing wind came from heaven. There was a sound, the Bible says. A
yeah.
mighty rushing wind.
Yep.
And they begin to do this, and what did they ask? What meaneth this?
Yeah. Are they drunk?
And the next question is, what must we do?
Yeah.
You know why people aren't asking what must we do? Because they're not asking the question, what meaneth this?
Yeah.
You know, because people come to church so many times that they don't expect anything to happen. You talk about your Aunt Mary Lee and how she prayed. You know, I know people who actually prayed and believed that God was going to answer the prayer.
Oh, yeah. Amen.
I remember being around people and they talked. The first thing that was it, I looked that up on Google. Her first answer was, let's pray about it. And they prayed. And when it happened, they thanked God for it. They knew who to thank you for
yeah.
the day.
Yeah, that's true.
These women came to see. Amen.
Yeah.
You don't sit with the women that came and not the men. That's not good for us. But I was just saying that the women that came. And they came first. And you know what? They got to see, didn't they?
Yes, they did.
They got there. The soldiers were gone. The stone was moved. The angels sitting up there. They got to see all of that. The snow, the rain, the raiment. The handsome angel said to the women, fear not ye, for I know that ye seek Jesus, which was crucified. And with all of this happening, I think about all that happened. Chrissy, remember all those things that God kept leading our way when we were lost. All those people God kept coming by. Brother George Riggs and Mabel Riggs stopping me out there beating on a punching bag, and I wouldn't even stop. I just kept beating on that bag, inviting me to church, trying to tell me about Jesus. You know, over there having a prayer meeting next door, praying for us and stuff. People kept coming, you know. But the Bible says, fear not ye, for I know ye seek Jesus. They that come seeking God have nothing to fear.
Amen.
Those who come trying to disprove this Bible and trying to do everything they can to disrupt, they got a lot to fear.
Yeah.
But you know, those who come with an open heart and say, Lord, I just want to know if you're real or not, they ain't got nothing to fear.
Yeah.
Amen. They came to see, and guess what God did? Yeah. He let them see. Amen. And not only that, the Bible says, he's not here. For he is risen. As he said, come, see the place where the Lord lay.
See.
You imagine that? I told this story before about the man who traveled all the way to Israel. He got over there and walked in the tomb of the sepulcher. Looked in there and said, I don't see what everybody's excited about. There ain't nobody in there. He missed the whole point.
Yeah.
That's the point. He's not there.
That's right.
He's the one that got up and walked out.
Yep.
You know, you go over there and see Muhammad and all these other ones, Buddhists, Gandhi, it don't matter. You can go see their graves, they're still there.
Yeah.
You know, which one was it? Some communist leader or something. They entombed his body with glass and everything or around him so people could view him. Yeah. Might be Stalin is one of them. But they say now they had to do some touch-ups because it wasn't really
airtight.
Airtight, yeah. And, but Jesus ain't there. Yeah. And the angel wanted them to know it. Come see the place where he lay. And one place the Bible talks about later on where Peter and John and them went racing over there, you know. And they went in and they looked and they found the linen, you know. They found what he was wrapped in, but they found that napkin folded off.
Amen.
Amen. Now that don't make a whole lot of sense to some people, yep. But yins know it. But you know what happens, you know, over there in that culture, if you were eating your meal, you know, then if you were done, you take your napkin and just throw it on your plate along with your silverware, and they knew that you were done, they could clear the table. But if you folded your napkin up neatly and placed it on the side, it was a statement saying, I'll be right back.
Yeah.
That's what Jesus did. When he rose from the dead, Bible says he went to the Father, didn't he?
Yes, he did.
Well, you know what he did? He laid that napkin down and he folded. He said, don't worry, I'll be right back.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
They came to see. He's not here. He's risen, as he said. Come see the place where the Lord lay. And go quickly, tell his disciples that he has risen from the dead. You know, if we could just get that part. If we come to the point, Brother Dave, that we really understand that our Lord and Savior died for us, that he went to the cross, and he paid in the price in full, that he was buried, and he rose the third day. If we could do like that Bible says, and go quickly and tell others that he's risen. Because we don't have a promise of tomorrow.
No,
sure. If we could go 24/7, Gary, we still wouldn't reach all the people that we need to reach.
Yeah. Amen.
You know, if we could just go out there and just have a meeting with them. But you know how hard things get in the way. Sometimes you might have one or two opportunities in a week, maybe, to tell somebody. But if we went like that, you know. But I still think we could get a little bit quicker in our steps, you know. If we could just go a little bit quicker. I guarantee you, when I get before the throne, I'm going to wish I did more for the cause of Christ. You know, I'll be sorry about the things I didn't do, you know. They went quickly. And look what happened as they were going. Go quickly, tell the disciples that he is risen from the dead. Behold, he goeth before you into Galilee. There shall you see him, as I have told you. They departed quickly from the sepulchre with fear and great joy, and did run to bring his disciples word. They were obedient to what they were told to do.
Amen.
Notice that. And then look. And as they went to tell his disciples, behold, Jesus met them, saying, all hail. You know where Jesus meets you sometimes? When you just start getting busy for him. Amen. It's kind of like worship. When we start lifting him up, he just shows up. You know? Yeah. You ever had that happen? You just go there, you go in there, Brother Gary, and you got a headache, and it ain't been going good all day, and you know, you don't even know, you just know you're here. You look around, there ain't nobody here. Lord, here I am. I'm going to praise you. And all of a sudden, you start making much of him. And he just pulls in right beside you.
Yes.
Amen.
Puts his arm around you and says, I'm proud of you, son.
I'm here.
Yeah. I'm with you. I don't care what the other crowd don't like it or not, I'm going to be with you. Amen. Amen. They went quickly, and as they were going, Jesus met them. There's times when I didn't know why I was doing what I was doing. I felt led of God to do it, but as I started doing it, and I got into it, he showed up. And then it all made sense. Amen.
Yeah.
It does make sense, but sometimes we got to go on faith. Amen. We love the feelings. I love the when my hair raises off my arms and I feel the power of God and I know there's something there and it just gets, but you know what? There's times when you got to just take a step on faith.
Yeah.
And say, Lord, I'm not there today. My body ain't there.
Yeah.
My mind ain't there. But my heart is. And I'm going to obey from the heart. And then everything else will catch up later on.
Amen. That's true.
It does. As they went, he met them. All hail. They came and held him by the feet, worshipped him, and said, Jesus, verse 10 unto them, be not afraid. But tell my brethren that they go to Galilee, there shall they see me. And you know, it's amazing. These women who had so much kind of detouring them and keeping them away, made up their mind. They said it in that statement, they came to see. You know? Yeah. I think about sometimes, and I'm not going to say this to embarrass him because Josh is here, but Josh, so many times I see him, and he goes to church. He plans on having church when he gets here. You know what I'm saying? And I've known some others like him, too, where they just planned on going. And they didn't know what their attitude was. Everybody, they didn't even care. As far as they're concerned, I'm going for him. They came to see. And they saw. Look what all that God did so that could happen. And you know what? God's no respecter of persons. He'll move mountains.
Yeah.
If that's what he needs to do to make a way for you. The Bible says he's ordained our steps, Brother Gary. God has a plan for us. He has a purpose. And you know, there's much to do out here. And he's looking, the Bible says, the eyes of the Lord move to and fro. And he's seeking whom he may show himself strong in.
Yep.
Be it man, woman, boy, or girl.
Yep. Amen.
He's looking for someone that will believe him and trust him and go for him. So God can get the praise and not us. Because if it's all about us and our learning and our PhDs and everything else, hey, they'll pat us all on the back, Brother Gary. Oh, you're a good old guy. You're a good guy. You know, but they're missing the point. If when they look at us, they got to know it's got to be God.
Yeah.
Because we couldn't have done that. We couldn't have or done anything.
No. That's true. Amen. Yeah.
But I really feel like these people had their heart in the right place.
They
Amen. Wanted to serve Jesus. They wanted to see him. He was their, they loved him. He was their friend. And God granted them that. There's much more said in these scriptures. Think about it. He did all that he said he had to do. His own disciples, those apostles that they're wonderful. But he asked them the night before he got arrested, could you not pray with me 1 hour?
Yeah. No.
You don't think about that. I see myself in that group, by the way. Sometimes, can you not watch with me 1 hour? And sometimes I think, Lord, I just want to do this. I'll give it up in a few moments, hours, days, whatever it is. Lord, I'm going to study and I'm going to do this. My own gunners don't get it done. I come up short. It's not about our performance. It's all about what he's done. Amen.
Yeah.
And I'm so glad he's merciful and he's graceful. No matter what it is, maybe you feel like tonight there's something in your way. I can only go so far. I'm limited in my education. I'm limited in my financial ability. Or I'm limited in my physical ability. Listen, I don't know what it is. I don't know what stone is in your way. But I feel like God would have us to move closer. He wants us to see.
Amen.
He wants us to know. You know, Paul had a desire. He said, now we look through a glass darkly. He said, but then face to face. You know, think about Joseph. Now, Joseph, we don't have a whole lot about what Joseph felt. But here was Joseph. He had these dreams. And he believed them. And for that, he got thrown into a pit.
Yeah.
Amen. He got sold into slavery.
Amen.
And then he became a prisoner. You know, and the next thing you know, he's second to the Pharaoh.
Yeah.
You know.
Every word of the throne.
Yeah. And you know what? In the end, Joseph had an understanding. His brothers thought, uh-oh, daddy's done. Daddy's gone. Joseph's going to get his revenge on us. Those brothers thought for sure Joseph was coming after him. And Joseph looked at him and said, you know, you meant it for evil. But God meant it for good.
Yep, amen.
I'm saying we may not get it quickly. But if we come to see and we come for his glory and his honor, story ain't done yet, Dave.
That's right.
You might have to write a third book. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
God's still working. He's still doing miracles. He's still looking for that one that he can use that'll give him glory and not seek it for himself.
Yeah. You know? Yeah.
And those are the kind of people that are looking for people out here that maybe they're not churched. Maybe, you know, I feel like I've said this before, but some churches want people that make the church look good.
Mm-hmm.
They want the lawyers or the well-to-dos or the well-looking or, you know, beautiful people. And they bypass these that they got issues. They bypass the ones that they're going to be problems. You know what? Jesus dealt with those people.
Yes, he did.
Even those that were demon-possessed. Even those that, you know, yeah. get the Lord. I love that verse where there came one worshiping him. And Jesus said, what would you that I would do with the Lord that I may be? You know? And Jesus, the Bible says, touched him, saying, and I always stopped right there, because it was illegal to touch a leper.
Yeah.
He was an untouchable. A leper had to cry out when he went down the road, unclean, unclean, stay away, because it was contagious. All his life, nobody hugged him, nobody reached for him, nobody shook his hand, nobody welcomed him, Dave, because nobody wanted what he had.
Mm-hmm.
It was a death sentence. And he came to Jesus and knelt. And Jesus touched him, saying, but even if he hadn't spoke a word, can you imagine what that felt like to that leper when Jesus put his hand on him and touched him? The law didn't allow it. But Jesus was above the law. He was more powerful than the law. Matter of fact, he said, before Abraham I was. When he touched him, he said, I will be not clean. And he was made clean. There are some that we look at and we almost feel like they're untouchables. I was an untouchable. People would look at me and says, he'll never amount to anything. He messed up too many times. But when God convicted me one night, I told the Lord, Lord, can't do this Christian thing. I've just messed up again. I know it was real and I deserve to go, but I wanted to see. Just like they came to see, I wanted to see. I said, God, if you'll save me, I'll give you my life. And I can remember as plain as this day, it's like a big old platter, all the mistakes, all the wrong I'd done, all the bad decisions, all that I'd done was on a platter. And it was right in front of me, and I just pushed it over and said, God, I'll give it all to you. And that night I accepted Jesus, and he saved me. And he opened my eyes. And I got up the next morning, and I'm looking in the trailer. Remember that dark trailer, Chris? The walls were so dark. And I'm looking around, and it just like brightened up. I'm like, wow, I don't remember this being like this. I looked at Chris and I said, wow, she's really pretty. I go out and I look at the grass. Wow, this grass is green. It's like I had been walking around in darkness. And I was, literally.
Yeah. Yeah.
And God opened up that to me. And God let me see.
Yeah.
You know, far from perfect. They, none of us are. But I got joy in my heart. Put a song in my heart.
Yeah.
And it gave me a story to tell. And I've got a purpose. And I want other people to see because I can see her. Mm-hmm. They may not all see it my way. I get that. I work with Amanda back here. She never sees it my way.
Sometimes.
Yeah. And Chris, we just learned how to get along. But you know what? You want people, when you find something that's really precious to you, I'll show you something. Look at that. Ain't that good? Go check that out. Go get with that. Yeah, when we get something precious, we want to share it.
Amen.
We want other people. And if we can, we want them to have it. Now, sometimes that only, you can't have mine. but sometimes it does. Yeah. Because you know what? The more we share of Jesus, I'm not any less for giving someone else my testimony. I don't have any less of his love by sharing that love. Matter of fact, I have more.
Amen.
Amen. So that's the wonderful thing about it, you know.
Amen.
I want other people to see, don't you? Man, we see people coming at flea market all the time, don't we? All kinds of states. There's some that can't, kids that come through and I've had my heart broken more than once, Dave, because the kids just want something. You know, kids are kids. Parents ain't got money. It's cheap entertainment. They just walk around, you know. And we should take care of everything. You can't. sometimes you can, you know, a little kid being a little rambunctious, you say, hey, does that little boy like cars? Can I give, is it all right if I give him a car? Oh, yeah, yeah, that's okay. And then the parents, you can see a smile come on their face because that's really what they want to do. They want to be good to them, but sometimes they got beans, you know.
The truth is, yeah.
If they can see themselves, how much God wants to give them, you know. If they could just see that God, their Father, wants to give them His best. Not to get anything back, but just to give them joy and peace and love and forgiveness and mercy, and give them a life. If we could get them to see that, then we've done our purpose here.
Amen.
Amen.
I don't know about you, but I just want other people to see. I want to see Jesus for who He is. He's not, God ain't just waiting to drop the hammer on people in judgment. And we're not waiting to just condemn them for every little thing. You know, we've all sinned and come short. We already know that. You know. But if they could see that there's grace and there's mercy today, while it's called today. You know, we don't have a promise of tomorrow. You know, that's one thing you gotta throw in there, Brother Gary. The offer is free, but the offer doesn't extend in infinite. You know, we've got from cradle to grave to get it right. I talked to a lady yesterday, she's 86 years old. Her husband's still living. And I said, you know, and she was starting out, well, what are you, a Scorpio or Taurus? She goes, did you feel bad last week? I said, lady, I don't believe any of that stuff. I said, look, I've preached the gospel, you know, for years. I've pastored 14 years. I said, I believe God's good. And I started talking to her. Oh, I believe in God. You know, they changed the whole tune, you know. But she was 80-some years old. And she got around pretty good. And I told her, I said, look, I said, we've got from cradle to grave to get this thing right. I said, believe in God's good. I said, well, Jesus is the Lord of heaven.
Amen.
You know?
Yeah.
And you've got to go through the door.
You know, journey, man.
Pray for her. Because she may come back and see me again. She likes to talk. I noticed that. And I just want people to see. I don't know. It's kind of been a while since I got to look at this scripture real good, but there's certain things in there I look at and I remember what struck me. You know, it's good to see someone. It's like that song about that woman who went into that men's meeting with that alabaster box.
Yes.
Yeah.
And it cost, some say it cost over a year's wage for that box of perfume. And once she broke it, there was no going back. Wasn't no lid you put back on it. She broke that box, it all poured out. And she wasted, they thought, she wasted it all. But you know what? The Bible says she was doing, Jesus said, she does this unto my burial.
Yeah.
She was preparing him. Yeah. And she gave it all. And she rinsed his feet with her tears. Boy, what an opportunity. Amen. Hey, she got a lot of mileage out of one box of perfume, I'm telling you. Still talking about it today. Almost as much as the woman who had 2 months. You know? Look at the return she got from that. I hope you see tonight. I hope you see more clearly. And I hope you can see one others to see as well. Amen. Let's bow our heads. Father, we thank you.